Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and this video is part of another collaboration. It's 50 cards for 50k to celebrate Justine Hovey reaching 50,000 subscribers. Over 50 card examples will be shown throughout the hop, and there are prizes to win. I will tell you more as I go along, so let's get started as there is lots to see. I start with adding a layer of gesso on my ultra smooth card, and I spread it with a brayer, and this is a quick way to add the gesso. For this hop I'm going to show you my favorite technique, and I have so many that I actually combined two. I let the cards dry before I go on to the next step, and they dry really fast. I have Vicky Boutin stencils, and I emboss the card with the stencils. I will link to a video where I tell you all about it. I'm going to use Distress Oxide inks, and I looked for an October color scheme and this popped up. So I'm going to color the cards with an ink blending tool, using the brightest three colors first, and I add them randomly in a turning motion. Now this hop is all about techniques, and if you would like to learn more techniques, you may like to check out my Stamping Without Stamps class, jam-packed with techniques and mark-making tools you'll discover in this class that you may already have right at home. And you can also check out Justine's Technique Resource Binder class. You can find both links in the description box. After I added all the colors, I blend them together a bit by going over them again, where the colors touch each other. And I want the colors to be a bit more bold. I was a bit careful by adding them in the beginning. Now, while the ink is still wet, you may like to use a piece of paper to hold the card so it doesn't get your fingerprints on it. And just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. And you can find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe, and make sure to subscribe to all channels you like. I'm going to color the next card too, but I add the ink in a different pattern. Now for the prizes you can win in this hop, make sure to hop along all the channels joining this hop. The more you visit and comment, the better chances you have on winning one of the 5 gift certificates of $50 sponsored by Justine. You can find the link to the next channel also in the description box. And now the magic. You need a wet wipe for this. Gently rub over the card, not pressing, just touching the top layer, and the gesso resists the ink, so the embossed layer will be lighter. And then you'll see the pattern from the stencil becomes more visible. The more you rub and the more you press, the more ink will come off. So just do it in bits to see the result and if you need to go over it again. And I dry it a bit with a paper towel. I finished the cards with the aged mahogany around the edges. And I have another way you can do this technique. I embossed the ultra smooth card first, and now I'm going to add a layer of gesso on the embossed and the debossed side. And this way the gesso will touch the pattern from the stencil, and parts of the paper will have no gesso. I roll the brayer really well in the gesso. I want a thin layer on it so it only covers parts and doesn't get in the creases. And then I'm going to let the cards dry again. I'm going to use the same colors. I'm going to apply the ink in different patterns. It's just fun to play with the inks a bit to get different looks. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? available on smartphone and desktop computer. I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes, sneak peeks, polls and such, so you can check that out if you like. And then I come in with a wet wipe again. You turn the wet wipe a few times so you have a clean piece again, and just wipe off the ink until you like the look. I colored the edges with the aged mahogany again, and I'm going to add just bits of black for contrast. This makes the other colors pop. I'm going to make some splats with white gesso on the lighter cards. I do dilute the gesso with some water, and I'm going to tap on the brush to make some pretty splats. I do the same with black gesso on the darker cards, and then I'm going to let that dry. You can skip adding the splats if you want. I always like the touch of white and black to lift the colors, and it looks more playful. I cut some bigger cards as a card base, and I burnish the fold with a precision glide, and then I add a colored card on top with tape. And here are the cards so far. I cut some letters out of chipboard with a Tim Holtz alphabet die, and I colored them with ink. I use the same ink from the color scheme for all four cards. I just show you this one for the sentiment. I have some pieces of masking tape sticky side up on a piece of chipboard, and I press the letters in the embossing ink, and then I dip them in the embossing powder. And this goes best with two letters at once. They stick a bit to the tape, but it's not foolproof. And the closer they are, the harder it is to have them stay put. And I use the craft pick to press them down a bit. You can add them on the tape first and then add the embossing powder, but I find that such a waste of powder. And this is the pretty gloss finish you get. So I add the sentiment to the card with glue, and then I'm going to put my acrylic block on to let them dry. I love this glue because it has such a fine tip. You can add little amounts of glue and you don't need another tip or anything else. and I finish the cards with some drops. I have the drops I'm using stored upside down in the color case, having the drops right where they need to be at the tip of the bottle. These are the finished cards. I hope it inspired you to get crafty yourself. It's a super fun technique, also great for beginner crafters. Make sure to hop along on the channels that are joining this hop, and I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and good luck, and make sure to keep on crafting.